Hey YouTube, Corpersan here. Today we're checking out the reworked Bishop in the MapleStory Korea test server. Like I mentioned in all the previous videos, this is still the test server. So some skills might still be buffed, nerfed or changed before they actually hit the live server. Please do keep that in mind. Archers are getting a new teleport skill and mages are getting an up jump. That kinda seems like a fair trade, right? All Explorer mages now in their first job get not only a massive up jump, they can also hold the jump button and directional keys to float after they jumped up. The up jump is sick for reaching platforms you normally cannot reach with your teleport skill. Also, the up jump and float can be quite useful during boss fights. I can imagine this ability being amazing to dodge the Dragon's Breath from Lucid and the Lightning Attack from Lotus. You can jump and then up jump, and teleporting in the air after the big up jump is possible as well, as long as there is ground to teleport to. Energy Bolt has gotten a buff this update and now hits way more lines. I also like the look of it, looks a bit cleaner, but it will never replace Magic Law. Like with the current Energy Bolt, this skill still cannot go through terrain, so training in flat maps is still preferred for mages at an early level. I was actually hoping for this revamp to remove some of the older, more useless skills, but unfortunately this is not the case. So some skills like passive magic armor that increases defense by a whopping 90 points is still there, for example. But besides the new look and up jump, mages are still pretty similar when it comes to grinding in first job. We take this second job advancement and become a holy cleric. I think slowly clerics are transforming into archers. Their holy arrow skill got a buff and it now looks like this, and now hits more monsters and does more lines as well. They still have that useless skill that clerics get more EXP when they party up with other clerics. Ha! Party grinding in MapleStory. Good one, Nexon. But your final damage is also increased based on the amount of party members in your party, so that is pretty nice. Heal is still there and has gotten a new look, healing party members and damaging undead monsters like always. Heal has a 4 second cooldown, but this is decreased by 2 seconds for every party member healed. And using heal no longer leaves a debuff, but more about that later. Bless has gotten a new animation as well, and as expected, their booster skill has become a passive skill. Looks like this is indeed the case for all explorer classes, that all their boosters are now passives. Thanks to their revamped Holy Arrow, which has a pretty big hitbox, training goes pretty smooth in second job. But the hitbox on the skill does seem to be smaller closer to your character and wider further away from your character, so sometimes you expect to hit monsters, but actually you don't. In third job, priests get some shiny new skills, like really shiny. Shining Ray is very bright, but I do like the new animation and it has a pretty big hitbox, and actually looks like the hitbox of this skill extends a bit further to the bottom than it does to the top. Bishop's teleport boost has also been divided into two skills after this update. Teleport Mastery, which is a toggle that allows you to deal damage when teleporting and can stun monsters like normal. And Teleport Boost, which actually increases the range for your teleport both horizontally and vertically. This can be helpful during boss fights where you want to move around without actually hitting or aggroing the boss. Besides that, skills like Holy Fountain that can be used to heal yourself and party members, Bless, Holy Symbol and all the other skills are still there and they have gotten a new look. Grinding a third job was not bad at all thanks to Shining Ray. Also, bishops get a ton of crit rate, which makes them pretty easy to level up. Wait a second, high crit rate, holy arrows, bishops actually an archer confirmed. While grinding in MapleStory Korea, you sometimes also get a fun minigame that I'm sure will trigger some people who play MapleStory M. And the message that you get when you complete this minigame is actually pretty ominous. Enjoy your life? Like, what would have happened if I failed? By the way, mages can also dodge Zakum's arm slap by jumping in the air. It's a pretty convenient skill, I kinda like it. For job, this class has gotten some big changes. Angel Ray will now always only hit one monster and it will still heal the party members it hits. Basically, this skill now acts as it would when you had Righteously Indignant active at Hyper skill. Also, enemies hit by the skill will get a stacking debuff that will increase the final damage of your party members by 2% against that monster. This effect stacks up to 5 times. Genesis has gotten a new look, and hits from Genesis after the revamp now have a 25% increased chance to be a critical hit, unlike the 20% critical hit chance it has now. Big Bang also has a new look. Now you really can't see your character anymore when you use it. This skill is the same, except for that the stacking debuff the skill had is now gone. Also, your dragon has got a new look. Personally, I don't really like it that much. It kinda looks like a Pokemon instead of a dragon, but let me know what you think. Most people that saw it on stream kinda liked it. There is also a new 4-job skill called Holy Water. This skill accumulates stacks when you hit monsters with Angel Ray. Once you hit enough monsters, you can create a Holy Water Chalice. Party members can use this to recover HP by hitting up near the chalice. Now you might be thinking to yourself, whoa, okay, looks like Bishop hasn't really gotten that many changes overall. But nope, the biggest change is yet to come. Bishop's their level 140 Harper skill has been changed. Now you can enter two modes, Support Mode or Vengeance Mode. In the support mode, everything is fine and your skills will be the same. But go into vengeance mode and all hell will break loose. Your third job, Holy Fountain, will change from a fountain of healing to a fountain of death. Place it down to deal damage to nearby enemies. This spell now also will start dispelling the life of monsters. Use that skill to periodically summon feathers that fly around and deal damage. You know, just like archers. Heal will, instead of healing, summon a small angel that deals damage and debuffs enemies that reduces their defense for 40% when you hit them. And finally, your Holy Water skill will turn into Holy Blood. When using this skill, your healing abilities will be reduced to only 1% of its efficiency, so like 99% less healing, and you'll take 20% more damage, but your damage is increased by 15%, and the duration of this skill is increased passively by 1 second for every 3000 in that you have. And finally, passively, this new hyper skill also increases magic attack by 50, gives 30% final damage, 20% ignore enemy defense, and 10% elemental attribute reduction. That's passively. Just put 1 point in that skill, you get all of those bonuses. This skill is definitely a big change for bishops. They can now switch between being supportive and skills more oriented to grinding and bossing. Considering I am weak AF with no Legion or Link skills, it is only expected that those skills don't deal a lot of damage for me. But for high level bishops, these new skills can be a great way to improve their grinding and get more on par with their Ice Lightning and Fire Poison Mage brothers and sisters. What do you think of the new bishop? Godly or a godly disappointment? Let me know in the comments. Next class that we're going to show is the Buccaneer. We are live once this video goes up, so if you want to check out that class, feel free to hop over to our Twitch channel. We will be training every revamped class live and will answer any questions you have about MapleStory, of course. And that was all for today for this video. Thank you all so much for watching and thanks to our members for making this video possible. As always, many thanks to Niels de Konnik, Rama Waar, Sebastian Hanoi, FLX, Riley Oz, Terry Kim, Varese, Kalimora, Wiley, Francisco Sousa, History Cannon, Backspace OTI, Sophronix, Lonzo, BG Extremes, Anwar NHI, Frank Bouguet, Ziggy Deer, Flidiot, BeamerWT, Knifezoo, Chen125, Cloudfix, Gusus Rodriguez, Froggy11, SirTito655, Glason, Brendan Cam, Vira, Trevor, Michael Majaka, Ratius, Lucky Beats, Justin Vale, Silvio Nato, Stevie Zhang, Afterlord_MS, Heyopan, Simak, Joshua Alvarez, Striker Elk, Nokam SS, Niu, Tide1 Pan, Victor Sundstrom, Radicals the Alien, Stanislaus Kosumo Begus, Riser RU, Eddie Reacts to Things, Dular, Gummy Bullet, Leon Riddle, Booty Warrior GT, Jeremy Stotler, Mr. Anark, Lovebird, Rev Soli, Yuruski TV, Yo Mama, Matthias Simonson, Caveman, oh yeah, and Galando Balavia. Thank you all so much for watching. Stay safe and happy mapling!